to know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
In the northern corner of Mumbai is a cluster of villages in a strict contrast to the overpopulated cosmopolitan city. It's a weekend getaway to visit the Manori Island. After taking a ferry from the Marwe beach, you reach the Manori Island, inhabited by East Indians for centuries. The East Indians are a community that go back a long way in Mumbai. They are the original inhabitants of the city. The indigenous Catholic inhabitants who lived in the region, in Salsit and in Basin, now known as Vasai. Hidden within the Manori Island is the Kaka Baptista East Indian Museum, or the Mumbai Museum, named after the former Mumbai mayor and activist Joseph Baptista, which depicts the story of Mumbai's East Indian community over the last 200 years. This museum is an initiative by the Mumbai Gautan Panchayat to collect, preserve and draw inspiration from their material heritage. The collection here has been built thanks to the donations of artifacts by members of the East Indian community. They include an assortment of everyday wear that tell many stories of the life and times of the community in Mumbai. Alfie D'Souza, the founder trustee of the museum and sarpanch of the local community, is the man behind the museum.
We started Mumbai Gautan Panchayat in 2010. March 2010 to be exact, here at Manori. The first project that we took up in 2010, when we founded the Mumbai Gautan Panchayat, we had our first project as the museum, East Indian Museum, which we named after Kaka Baptista, the East Indian leader, who was very famous along with Lokmanya Tilak. He founded the phrase, freedom is my birthright and we shall have it. So initially we had to have it in the huts, two huts. But then 2 years down the line, a monsoon came and devastated the huts, which was in a way a blessing in disguise, because that gave birth to the museum that you see today. It's a pota type of cabin built by Clyde Hendricks, the boat maker, who also donated a fiberglass boat.
The museum has rare artifacts of the community, which include traditional musical instruments like kumat and saxophone, earthen and traditional kitchen utensils, plowing equipment like koita, khawni, dantela, and a lot more.
Around 10 years ago, we realized that our community, from the culture perspective and overall, is kind of dwindling as time passes by. So we already had a particular setup in Juhu on a civic side called as Garaj. As things passed by, we realized the community needed a lot of things in terms of revival of culture, restoration of our places, okay, and promoting our culture to a great extent. And there was a great need, because the new generation was slowly forgetting, okay. And even the past generation was going with the new times. So taking those things into account, there was an urgent need felt ki, yes, we need to do something for the community. So what we decided is, we wanted to start something like a panchayat, which was followed in the olden times, wherein we have a group of people who decide what is to be done on the social, civic side of the community. And so we decided to have a panchayat. But then we had a core team who said, no, it may not work, it's not fine. So then we decided, let's have it in at least one place, see it has a model, how it works, and then we can take a call. So after we started the Gautan Panchayat, there were quite a lot of things, civic things. Are the people who were elected were called sarpanches, and they started working on the local. Although they were not recognized by the system, but they did their work, and the work was manageable because they were coordinating with the cooperator, the MLA. After a few months, we realized that since this is working, let's make it all Bombay or throughout the East Indian community. And that's when we decided to call it the Mumbai Gautan Panchayat.
The East Indians not only want to promote the memory of Kaka Baptista's multiple identities as an East Indian, a Roman Catholic and Indian nationalist, but also trace the roots of the community through this museum.
Future generation would not know what their culture is. Like today, if I have to ask my my children, they may not know much. But if they come here, they see a lot of things. They start questioning, asking us what is it. The person over here may try to explain. We have various display boards which tell you about what is the thing, what it is called, what is meant to be. So this thing will at least keep those cultural aspects in mind. Even though some things may be forgotten in future, it will always be seen as something which will remind them that, okay, our forefathers used to travel like this. They used to wear clothes like this. This was the jewelry. This were the kind of books which were there. This was the music which we had. So all these things, the utensils they had, this will revive and make them recollect as to how their forefathers went ahead with their culture and tradition. So we have a Kristi Puran. It's a booklet. It's about religious hymns sung by a community in the past. And it has a lot of relevance in the Lenten season. Okay, people still sing it. It sounds really well during this Lenten time when we are fasting and abstaining from things. Okay, so that's one thing which we have here, a booklet which has the entire hymns of which are sung in Kristi Puran. Then if you go, we also have the ghumat, which is a musical instrument. Okay, it's a prominent instrument because no occasion is complete without a ghumat, because the ghumat is a part of it. It's a pot-sized music instrument. Okay, which has a skin on one side and a hollow on the other side. And it's like a drum, actually, basically. So that is one instrument which is there. Then we have something called the lugra, which is a traditional attire, which the ladies wear always. And it's becoming a tradition nowadays. Even the men are wearing the shirts and the ladies are making tops or dresses out of the material. Also, one more thing which we have revived here are two things. One is the native religious traditions. So native religious tradition would mean we have a saint from our community who has his roots in the community called as Saint Gonzalo Garcia. And we consider him as a patron saint, and he was born in Vasai, so from our community to some extent. And so we have decided to promote him. We have a statue of the Saint Gonzalo Garcia in the museum, and we also plan to make a chapel in his dedicated to him very soon. The other tradition religiously we have is Mount Mary, which is in Bandra. Now this is a local tradition. It started in Bandra, which is the heart of where a lot of East Indians used to stay at some point of time. So even here, we are trying to promote Mount Mary. So what we do is around the time the Bandra Fair, before the Bandra Fair, people know the Bandra Fair very well. So Mount Mary is related to the Bandra Fair. So before the Bandra Fair, so around a month before, we start kind of taking the statue of Our Lady from one Gautan to another. And this time we did it. It went to around 50 Gautans. So that way, by at least when the statue of Mount Mary visits, they at least recollect that there is a connect to our native religious traditions. The future, I wouldn't say is very bright, okay, but the future depends on how the community comes forward. The current scenario is very good. Okay, it sounds a little better than what it was 10 years ago. 10 years ago, I would say, I wouldn't expect so many things would have happened. So that itself is an indicator that if you connect with people, tell them how important it is to promote the culture and tradition, not all may come, but a decent number of them will come, and that will help us to grow. Today, as a group of Mumbai Outer Panchayat, we have the best of people, the best of talent. If it goes in the same ratio, I think we'll go to bigger heights, greater heights in the coming years. So that's what we see in the future. But of course, a little bit need for unity, which is an important aspect, and a little bit of people trying to understand the importance of revival and restoration of a community culture and tradition.
Today, Kaka Baptista East Indian Museum serves as an example for restoring and safeguarding a community's cultural legacy and offers a peep into the early life of the East Indian community. The latest addition here is a small cafe that serves up some original East Indian food and recipes. This is truly a window to the community and its history.